Breaking inputs of yet another horrifying crime having taken place against a toddler in a Delhi school. The update here coming in with the Delhi police now having been sent a notice to the school asking how a male staffer, the main accused in this being a male sweeper, how the male staff was allowed to enter a female washroom in school. The police have also asked the school to inform if they had done the verification of the accused here with the police. Delhi school here has maintained that they have two initiatives for school in Delhi. The Delhi police say that they have complaint boxes that are installed in the school. Staff, parents, children who need direct help from the police. These are, of course, with respect to initiatives. But more updates coming in with respect to investigations regarding this crime. Our correspondent Alok is getting us those details here. Alok, in what has been asked from the Delhi police of this school, in how much more time would we know of those facts?
Well, sir, this incident had happened on 5th of August, and in fact, the case was reported on 8th of August to the police, and then later after that, the police, after investigation, arrested the accused person yesterday when they recorded the statement of the girl and the family members of the girl. But as of now, that during the course of investigation, police has found out some lapses on the school side. In fact, what they found out how the sweeper was, and he was the male sweeper. In fact, how he was there outside the female washroom, and remember, this incident has happened inside the washroom of the school where the accused sweeper had lured the girl on the pretext of giving her the chocolate to that washroom where he sexually assaulted her. And later after that, when the girl came back to her house on the first day, she did not tell to her parents, but later when she had a complaint, when she had pain in her stomach, then she told her mother. Later after that, mother then spotted the thing. Then she took her to the medical examination and to the hospital, where they found out that the girl was sexually assaulted. Then they informed the local police, and following that, the police registered the case and started the investigation. As of now, the sweeper is in the custody of police, okay. But the police say that they have sent a notice to the school because they want the answer why the accused was around the toilet of the female toilet and the female washroom.
That's right. Absolutely. Well, Alok, please stay on with us. You have given us all details of the case which are available, the line of investigation which is currently on by the Delhi police. Let's throw this open to our panelists this afternoon. We have with us Aprashta Gautam. She's the president of the Delhi Parents Association. Ms. Gautam, thank you for being with us here. In your view, who is at fault? Would this be entirely the responsibility of the concerned school here? They, of course, still need to provide whether or not police verification was done of the main accused, who was a sweeper employed in the school for the past 15 years or so.
I personally feel all the concerned departments are responsible for this incident. Here I'm talking about the education department, DCPCR, Delhi police. Every department is definitely responsible for the negligence of all the orders. आपको याद होगा अगर हम प्रद्युमन केस की बात करें 17 नवंबर 2017 को भी दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट ने एक ऑर्डर पास किया था जिसमें मिनिमम सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड्स की हमने बात की थी. Whether it is related to any molestation case, fire safety, हम किसी से भी बात कर लें तो स्कूल के मिनिमम सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड्स उन्होंने बनाए थे. DCPCR ने भी हाल ही में, मैं DCPCR को क्यों इसमें इन्वॉल्व कर रही हूँ, DCPCR ने भी हाल ही में दिल्ली में दिल्ली डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स पे काम किया था एंड दिल्ली पुलिस का भी इसमें एक रोल है क्योंकि प्रद्युमन केस के बाद स्कूल के हर एक स्टाफ का वेरिफिकेशन जाना था. अब मैं इन तीनों डिपार्टमेंट से ये जानना चाहूंगी, एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट ने अगर उन नॉर्म्स का फॉलो किया होता, मैं 2017 के ऑर्डर की बात कर रही हूँ, अगर उसको फॉलो किया होता.
Absolutely. और ये 2017 का जो ऑर्डर जो आप मेंशन कर रही हैं, इसका डेडलाइन जो दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट ने दिया था कि 3 हफ्तों में, बी इट private or government schools across Delhi. 3 weeks deadline was given here to get things in order. This is with respect to CCTV installations in various areas and corridors in the school and police verification. Let's in fact get in a response here. Stay with us. We also have Mr. Saurabh Bharadwaj, spokesperson of AAP, with us. Saurabh, thank you for being with us. There are questions being asked, not just with respect to laxity of school authorities, but also for the Delhi government being the absolute top authority and ensuring things are in place. In this case, we still need to find out whether or not police verification was done. CCTV was installed, based on which the Delhi police has investigated the case here, but also more laxity both from part of the Delhi government and the school. Please respond.
I know the case and I do understand that there have been orders from time to time by the Delhi government to the schools, which includes the government schools as well as private schools, to ensure safety and security of kids. And believe me, I am also engaged with safety and security of kids through some of our legislative committees also. We are investigating few cases with respect to, you know, top schools in Delhi. One is Indian School, APJ School, KR Mangalam School, Summerfield School, where we have found, you know, there were laxities in safety and security. And believe me, when we try to take action, they get shelter from courts. For example, I'll just let you know, Indian School has a full-fledged basement, which is totally illegal. No authority knows that there is a basement, though they have a full-fledged basement. And we ordered sealing of that basement, and they went to a MCD tribunal, and MCD tribunal gave them a stay that no coercive action by the government, and that basement is running. Similarly, they have porta cabins, which is again a safety hazard,
no,
a fire
Saurabh,
hazard.
How do you explain that they get
when
safety
I come
from
to this
courts
school,
if this
Balwant
is a
Rai
notification?
Yes, Balwant Rai.
If this is a compulsory notification,
yes,
by the Delhi government, how,
yeah,
do schools
that's what
get
I'm
safety
saying.
From
that's
courts?
What? I am telling you the name. That's what I am saying. I am telling you the name of the school. Indian School was running full-fledged basement. Our committee went there, found it, reported it to the fire department. The fire department gave sealing orders to the MCD to seal the basement of the school. And then they went to the court, and the MCD tribunal has stayed the government from taking any action. Same happened in APJ School. In APJ School, the High Court has stayed the Delhi government from taking any coercive action. So it is a very unfortunate state of state and the country that, you know, courts sometimes, you know,
no, but Saurabh, this is once again shifting blame.
About this Balwant Rai,
which it has been established that you had a male sweeper in the area for girls' washrooms. Aprashita, please respond.
सौरभ सर को मैं बता देती हूँ, दिल्ली की अगर 1700 स्कूलों की बात करें, जिसमें से 80-90% स्कूल में बेसमेंट्स आज भी रन होता है, एंड वी हैव गिवन प्लेंटी ऑफ एग्जांपल्स, प्लेंटी ऑफ मेल्स टू द एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. अब रही बात, एक अगर स्कूल कोर्ट जा रहा है तो डिपार्टमेंट के पास डेफिनेटली ऐसे एजुकेटेड लॉयर होने चाहिए जो उसको वहां पे डिफेंड कर सके, अपनी बात को सॉलिडली रख सके. बैक टू दिस इंसिडेंट, फे मेरा यहाँ पे ये कहना है,
the focus Hello. Back to this particular case here, whether or
yes, exactly.
not a job that has been done earlier and establishing basements that have not been sealed. Stay with us, Aprashita. Saurabh, you as well, please. We need to get in our correspondent, Alok, getting us further details here. Alok, it's a question of whether or not, how long would it take for the school to respond that there was police verification available here for this concerned sweeper, the main accused in this case here? He was hired by them. He was there in the school for 15 years or so. What is the school saying on this? And the explanation on how a male staffer, a male sweeper, was allowed to be in the area of girls' washrooms?
Well, absolutely, that there is no explanation from the school side. And in fact, when we tried to talk to the school's version, to take the school's version on this case, they said that they have the female staff. In fact, they have two security female security guards in that premises who secure the things, and also that there are five female nannies also that who look after the kids. But the question that is what we are saying, that since the sweeper was working there for 15 years, for 15 to 20 years, what the police says, so whether there was their kind of, whether is any system of verification or not, because if the person is employed for such a long years, mm-hmm. is there any verification? That is, that means that the renewal of verification is not in place, or is it place that right. need to be answered by the in fact by the school authorities. And police says that they have asked them to write about that. So that is what the police is saying, that they are waiting for their response on this also. And apart from that, they are waiting their response on how the male staff was there around the toilet of the female children.
Right.
So that is these two answers that
undoubtedly
the police
there is a system of renewal of police verification which expires after a certain amount of years or a given period of a year, and that needs to be renewed periodically. Saurabh Bharadwaj, please respond to this, because this is a Delhi government's case wherein which your government had stated there is going to be zero tolerance for crimes that are taking place against children inside school premises. And this is as recent as 2017 here, wherein which your government took out a notification. Are you saying that the Delhi government is once again helpless?
No. I think you are trying to misinterpret me. What I am saying is that first of all,
no, because
I'm not
you're giving
here to
in other instances
school.
Here, wherein here which you're trying to say that the
what
school gets court
no,
protection.
No. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And I am giving you by name, you know. And I think even a Parajita who is sitting there
right,
knows
all right.
about
so
it.
So let's stick
that, you
to
know,
this
and
case
she's
here.
Herself
if this is a case, yes, Saurabh, but
running,
if this is a case wherein which police verification
and,
has
yes,
not been renewed
case,
after expiry,
let me.
The Delhi government being
yes.
the top authority to keep a check
yes.
on that.
I think, you know, Delhi police is an independent agency beyond the control of Delhi government. However, what I am saying about this particular school is that what I know about it is there were CCTV cameras available there, and they were basically, you know, through this CCTV camera, it was found out that, yes, the sweeper also went into the same toilet. But yes, there was a big serious lapse on the part of the school that they had not employed a female nanny for a washroom, which is being used by female students, which is a mandatory thing for the schools to do. And regarding this, the government did not come to know about it on the day when the registration was done. The registration of FIR was on 8th of August. The government came to know about it on 9th of August, for which the school's authority was pulled. That why did you wait for 24 hours to let the Department of Education know about it? And when we came to know about it, the same day a 5-member committee was made. It consisted of 2 deputy directors, 3 female principals of government schools. They went to the school, did a complete inquiry. They have submitted the report to the government. A show cause notice has been issued to the school about not just the school sweeper, which is being prosecuted. We have asked the school that who are the others in the administration of the school who are responsible for ensuring that there should be no, you know, male staff in the female toilets. And we will recommend, or we will basically
right.
know, ensure that a strict action is taken against the school authorities as well. We'll not, you know, we'll not leave it just to for the
Aprashta, please respond to this here, because
we will fix the responsibility.
Can this
the
be a case
well.
Of a crime that has been taken under the crime that has occurred under exceptional circumstances here? Here is a school which had CCTV installed. Here is the Delhi police which arrested soon after the complaint. Who's to blame then?
I think there is a lapse at the level of a school management, because they were to ensure.
Yes, Saurabh, let's have Aprashta. Let's have Aprashta respond to that, please.
Aprashta Gautam,
please go ahead.
Girl kids.
Saurabh ji, यहाँ से स्कूल मैनेजमेंट की गलती नहीं है. अगर दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट ने एक कमेटी बनाने को बोला है एंड देयर इज अ प्रोविजन, वहां पर आप लोगों ने पूरा प्रोसेस बताया है कि स्कूल में एक कमेटी बैठेगी, उसमें ये लोग होंगे, वीकली आप इंस्पेक्शन करेंगे, वीकली आप सेफ्टी चेक वॉक होगा उसमें। आप मुझे ये बताइए, अगर मैं आज आपसे पूछती हूँ, क्योंकि आप बहुत सारी चीजें हैंडल कर रहे हैं, मैं आपसे पूछूं कि ये स्कूल भी बाई चांस आपके एरिया में आ रहा है, क्या आपने कभी अपने एरिया में आने वाले स्कूल में ये चेक किया है कि 2017 के बाद कितने स्कूलों में वीकली या 15 डेज में सेफ्टी वॉक हो रहा है? स्कूल सेफ्टी वॉक का आप ही ने ऑर्डर निकाला ना, 17-11 right. अगर मैं ऑर्डर को रेफर करूं तो
एब्सोल्युटली
सौरभ, मैं थोड़ा सा
सौरभ, व्हाट इज द टाइमलाइन दैट द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट मेंटेन्स टू कीप अ चेक, एंड इफ दैट चेक इज बीइंग डन? यस अप्राश्ता, वी गॉट योर पॉइंट सौरभ, इफ दैट चेक इज बीइंग डन के साथ इस दिल्ली में, अप्राश्ता लेट मी आस्क द क्वेश्चन हियर प्लीज, वी गॉट योर पॉइंट सौरभ, इफ दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट इज ऑन रूटीन कीपिंग अ चेक ऑन दीस रिकॉर्ड्स, देन यू वुड हैव द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस केस एज वेल।
Yes.
Sort of, yes. We would expect the Delhi government to keep records even concerning this school as well, if the checks have been done in time.
Yes, we have the records. Look, the government will have records, but I, as a spokesperson of the party, will not carry records to your studio. The government will all obviously have records.
No,
we have the whole report about the incident.
You would have the record. The government, the government would have the record.
If you have all the requests, all the records with you,
obviously
why don't
government
you
will
yes,
sort
of. If the government has the records, we would know. We would know whether or not this school has erred or not. Sort of, if you got
yes,
my
the
question
has
here,
the, record.
The government is maintaining these records.
The report, yes.
नहीं तो इसमें कमिटी सेटअप करने की क्या जरूरत है?
Yes.
आपके पास रिकॉर्ड्स हैं, आप दिल्ली पुलिस को रिकॉर्ड दीजिए दैट द स्कूल वॉज नॉट लिसनिंग टू यू. Police verification was not done. Police
no,
verification
records,
was not renewed. How
think,
difficult is
I
that?
Think, no. I think you are mistaken. I think you are confusing the issue. What I am saying is the committee was constituted to investigate this particular incident and whether there were lapses on the part of school with respect to certain orders which have been passed from time to time. Secondly, the committee is of the school. You know, the government doesn't have a committee of its own which goes there every week, because it is impossible for a government committee to visit each school every week. So it is the committee which is there as a permanent committee in the school, which is there to ensure that these things happen, and they happen in a way they should be. Now, coming up to the thing related to CCTV camera, I think the representative who is sitting in your studio, they are the ones who oppose CCTV cameras in the government school. They did a dharna at Jantar Mantar saying that there should be
no this was inside classrooms. We're just talking about CCTVs in corridors and open areas. We're not even getting into that discussion of CCTVs inside classrooms. Let me in fact get in that input here from our correspondent Alok. Alok, regarding this school.
A is equal to B nahi kar sakte ho.
Absolutely. Alok, regarding this school here, when was the last, if we have that information, when was the last that they submitted that report to the Delhi government that they should have been doing regularly based on renewal of police verifications, based on workings of CCTVs in their premises?
Well, as per the record from the school, we haven't got the original record when they had sent the original where the CCTVs are working or not, what are the security measures they are taking. Right now they haven't told the media also, and as well as the police also. That is what the police is in fact waiting. But let me tell you, the important part here is that the CCTVs, the Delhi government's program of installing the CCTV in various schools, and in fact all schools in Delhi, that they have started, and they have in fact started it in the classrooms also. And that is what that is what there were people who had objected it for, that it may hamper the privacy of the teachers also, and also the children also.
That's right.
That is what the people had questioned. But in this case, the such kind of assault has happened. So yes, the police is still waiting, and in fact the media, because the school administration has not come out with the exact analysis of exact report of when they had submitted the report to the government.
That's right. Aparajita, in your view, what does this establish? Are there grey areas that the law would need to work upon furthermore? Or is it just a case of what we have typically seen in so many years in the past as well? The police blaming the state government blaming the police, the school authorities blaming the police or the government. It's a blame game, and those getting victimized here are our children.
We need more laws. क्योंकि इम्प्लीमेंटेशन अगर नहीं होता, लास्ट ईयर भी सेम केस पे ऐसे ही केस था दिल्ली का, जिसमें हम ये इन्हीं बातों को लेके बात कर रहे थे. अब मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि आप एक ऑर्डर निकालते हैं, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन का आप चेक करते हैं. सौरभ भारद्वाज सर, इसमें मैं ये कहना चाहती हूँ, एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट है, लेट मी करेक्ट यू, वो दे आर नॉट डूइंग देयर जॉब, दो दे आर गेटिंग सैलरी फॉर दिस प्रोफाइल ओनली, फॉर दिस जॉब ओनली, but they are not performing. आप मैंने एक सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड की बात की है, मैं बहुत सारे की बात नहीं कर रही, आई एम नॉट गोइंग कि आपको ये चीजें नहीं, मैं सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड की बात करूं जहां पे ग्रे एरिया की बात कर रहे हैं. तो आप मुझे बताइए, मिनिमम सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड में वीकली सेफ्टी वॉक होना था, मीटिंग्स होनी थी, MOM. अभी आपने बोला कि आपके पास ये सारे रिकॉर्ड हैं, तो मेरा आपसे प्रश्न है सर, अगर आपके पास रिकॉर्ड है तो आप उसको पब्लिक क्यों नहीं करते हैं? मैं एजुकेशन के साइट में जाके मैं भी चाहती हूँ देखना, एज ए एक्टिविस्ट, एज ए रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ दिल्ली पेरेंट्स, मैं भी चाहती हूँ कि किस किस स्कूल का क्या रिकॉर्ड है. क्यों नहीं आप एक सिस्टम ऐसा क्रिएट करते, एक स्कूल को आपने एक कोड दे रखा है, तो एज ए पेरेंट मैं किसी भी स्कूल का चेक कर सकती हूँ कि कितने केसेस स्कूल में हुए, पॉक्सो के कितने केसेस हुए, जेजे के कितने केसेस हुए, कितने केसेस उनमें सॉल्व हो चुके हैं, और क्या वो स्कूल के पास ये सारे मिनिमम सेफ्टी स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉलो कर रहा है नहीं कर रहा.
Saurabh Bharadwaj, if you could please respond on this simple question here, this notification that was released by the Delhi government in 2017, iska renewal time period, what was the renewal time period? Whether it's a renewal of police verifications or installation of CCTV cameras, a check that would be kept in minimum which time period? How does Delhi government follow that?
I don't know exactly, you know, because I haven't read that notification, but I would like to say, you know, one thing, and I think you can cross-check it anyway. You have journalists, you have friends, you have researchers. I think this is the only elected government across the country and in the history which has got maximum number of cases against the private schools, whether it is about hike in fee,
Aparajita, we got your point.
You can ask.
Saurabh, please complete your point. My only point here being that it is shocking. You're quick to issue a medal to your government that they have taken historic moves here, but there is no follow-up. These are just one bit, one time announcements with no follow up. That is exactly what the Delhi government does each time. You make mega massive announcements here. They're seen as populist. They're seen as being doing work for people, but there is no follow up. What has been the follow up since 2017 then?
How is it that you don't know the details?
Or what is the minimum period of renewal?
I am throwing a challenge to you, madam.
I don't need any challenges to be thrown at me, sir.
You need to be answerable to the people of Delhi.
This is not about me and you, for God's sake.
You absolutely not.
It is an absolute shame for you to be speaking in this manner. Absolutely not. Nevertheless, we appreciate you being with us here. Our correspondent Alok as well for getting us those details. The big takeaway from here being that a crime has taken place against a minor. The Delhi school is not giving the specifics to the Delhi police. The Delhi government would have that on their records, but they say that they haven't. They'll need to cross-check. At the end of the day, it is the children. It is our children falling victim to crimes in our own schools. And this is despite having faced several crimes in the past. The Delhi government, concerned government, saying that they're taking corrective measures, but nothing is working on ground. Thank you for being with us.